Welcome back to my channel, and today I have a very special treat for you guys. If you guys don't know, that last Sunday there was a helicopter crash in Calabasas, California, and 9 people were killed. Unfortunately, among those 9 was Kobe Bryant and his daughter Gianna Bryant. So today I'm just doing a look to give tribute to Kobe and his team, the Lakers, that he played for 20 seasons, and just for all the makeup lovers. So if you guys are interested in this look, please stay tuned. Okay guys, so I already have my eyes prepped, and first I'm going in with my Zulu by Juvia Places palette. You guys have to excuse this palette, I have used it so much so it is so freaking dirty, but I'm using that yellow shade to start off with, and my blending brush I have from Morphe. So I am going to take that and put that in my upper crease area. I really want to do like a halo eye, so my objective of this part is just to blend, like I said, in my upper crease area. And this is just going to act as my backdrop color for the rest of the eyeshadows to be blended over top of it. So I'm just steadily blending and trying to get this into like a half circular type of shape. I am now blending the other eye really quickly because you see what I did on the first clip. I'm just basically doing the same thing. I'm just going in with that yellow shade, blending it continually. And I'm using a little bit of shadow and I'm building up the color. Like, I don't go in with lumps of yellow at first. I just slowly build and make sure the color is nicely blended all together over time gradually. Next, I'm going back in with that Zulu palette from Juvia's Place again. This time I am going in with the purple shade, and as you guys know, the colors for Lakers is mainly purple and yellow, and there's a pop of white in their uniform as well. So I am taking that purple shade next, and this is going to be for my inner and my outer corner, and this is going to form the halo eye. I'm using my small blending brush from Morphe again. I'm starting out by blending this purple shade into my outer corner, and like I said, I am taking a little bit of shadow at first, and I'm slowly going to apply more layers to build up that color. I don't want to go in with gollops of color at first because I don't want it to be very patchy and not blend really well. You want a nice and smooth canvas and transition between your eyeshadow colors. And again, I'm going back in with that purple shade again, and this time I'm actually blending this into my crease area, and I am trying to blend this underneath the yellow color so it can act as if sort of like a cut crease. But again, I'm doing this in a half circular shape, and this is going to transform into the halo eye. So I'm going back and forth between both of those eyes and just blending my color so they turn out seamlessly. I needed some water. I love Essentia, is my favorite water. It's alkaline, girl. Next, I'm taking my Pro Concealer in the shade Yellow Corrector. And basically what I'm going to be doing now is using my flat brush, and I'm going to be carving out the center part of my eye, and that's going to act as my cut crease. And I'm only going to do the center of my eye because, again, I'm doing a halo cut crease. So what you want to do is just take some concealer and draw a half circular shape into your crease area. You really want to take your time with this, you don't want to rush it, and also drag the paint down towards your lash line, and this is how you will form a base for your center color to go on to.
Sometimes you love too hard, sometimes you go too far, got you if you need me. Real things do not come easy, no. Never been your ever.
Next, I'm taking my Morphe 35B palette. I'm going in with that white shade. And if you had to guess, I am going to put this right in the middle of my eye. I'm going to be taking my Morphe flat brush. Actually, no, that is from BH Cosmetics, excuse me. I have so many brushes, I do not remember all of these names and the numbers. But I'm taking that white shade and I'm putting it in the center of my lid. And this is going to act as my, you know, cut crease color. As you can see, my eye is shaped very like a moon or a circle or a halo. That's the reason why they call it a halo cut crease. Because we have that purple and the yellow behind, and the white is the center focal piece. So I'm just steadily packing on that white color onto the center of my lids. Next, I'm taking my Rainforest by the Sea palette by Tarte, and this is my first time ever using this. Shout out to my bestie who got this for me when she had her BoxyCharm. So I'm using that really light champagne type of white color, and I'm just going to put that over top of my white shadow. And really, I could have put that eyeshadow color right on top of the concealer to make it, you know, more prominent and stand out, but I really wasn't thinking. I was just like, let me put a base down and then I'll build on top of that if I want something else. I really was gonna leave the white color, but then I thought, you know what, I really want something else to give it a little bit more of a vibe, so I'm gonna add this really nice pretty champagne color on top of it. So I'm just blending that in with my flat brush from BH Cosmetics. Already applied my lashes and my eyeliner off camera. I'm taking that Pods moisturizer. I love this stuff and it's so cheap. You can get it at the dollar store. I'm using this to prep my skin and I'm gonna act, you know, using this as my primer. Most of the time I really do use a primer. I use Maybelline's 24 hour for the dry skin, but this Pods crema has been getting me right here lately. Next, I'm taking my 24 Hour Stay foundation from Maybelline, and I'm in the shade 330, and I'm so sad because it's almost finished. I've had this foundation for, like, seriously, I think 4 or 5 months, and it's just been amazing. So I'm just using that with my beauty blender from Real Techniques, and this sponge is incredible, you guys, and it's under $5. Like, I have never used another sponge besides this one. It just gets the job done. So I'm steadily blending out the other side, trying to make sure everything is seamlessly. If you guys want to see a foundation routine, please leave any comments below and let me know. So next I'm going back in with my Pro Concealer. And this is actually in the shade Pure Beige. So this is like 2 shades lighter than my actual skin tone. And this is what I used to highlight. I love this concealer because it is so full coverage and it just like... I mean, it's so flawless after it gets blended. Like, it's really hard to detect any bad lines, you know, wrinkles. It kind of covers up bags as well, but I just love it overall in general. And I just wanted to tap up my bottom liner with the purple and yellow shadow, so I just went back in. Next, I'm taking my Airspun powder. And I really love this powder as well. You guys, you can get this from Walmart. I think you can even get it from the dollar store. I've seen it in there before. And Walgreens is a very flawless translucent powder with no flashback. And I just love it. I don't bake my face or anything like that. I just pretty much blend it in. I don't let it sit because I'm a dry person. So I don't like my foundation to get creased and caked and stuff like that. So I'm just blending this all in. Next, I'm taking my Wet n Wild contouring palette, and I'm using that brown shade to contour my face. And I really like this color because it's not really deep, and it's like a rich brown. It like gives you enough, like it's, I don't know how to explain it. Like it has a gray cast type of undertone, but also has like a warm cast. So I think it's perfect for me. And then next, I'm also taking a Wet n Wild product. I'm using this highlighter. I love this highlighter. It's like a gold type of shimmery color. It just looks very rich. As you guys can tell, I am definitely a drugstore girl. Like, I would say 75% of my makeup is for sure drugstore and 25% is high-end, because I really have used so many high-end products, and I just feel like drugstore is just as good, if not better, in my opinion. And I'm just highlighting my nose and my Cupid's bow. Lastly, I'm taking that MAC lipstick, and that is in the shade Among the Stars. I really like it. It's like a nice pastel type of pink color. I really wanted to do like a nude lip with this look, but I really could not find my nude lipstick. So I was like, let me get something that will still go pretty well with this look. And I think the pink, the yellow, and the white, and the purple, they all came together. Next, I'm going in with the MAC lip gloss, and I believe this shade is called Aspiring Star, and I'm just using that over top of my shade to just give it a little bit more of a pop. So this is the final look, you guys. I really hope you all enjoyed this video. Please comment. Do not forget to subscribe and hit that post notification bell to see other videos. See you next time.